Okay, now we're going to install the brackets. In this case, I want my brackets to be super secure, so I'm going to add some super glue to the screws. You don't need to do this. It's not necessary, but you can if you want.
Oh, wait.
So since we're using super glue, I put this piece of paper on top of the screen just in case I drop it. So be really careful. There we go. That's a clue to not keep trying it anymore. Remove the paper. And we are ready to install the parallel light. Now that the brackets are secure, we're ready to install the parallel light. It goes face down and the connection is going to be away from the motherboard. Carefully put it in there. Align all the holes. And here we're going to use the medium screws. Now that all four are in there, we can go back and tighten them. Make sure this is very tight. We're ready to install the fan. The right way to install this is the letters go with the parallel light. So, and also this cable facing, towards you. Okay, so in here you will notice that almost all of these look the same, but there are two that are a little wider. We're going to align the screws on the wider side, and to screw it in there, you'll have to apply a little force every time you turn. Since we only have two screws, we'll do it diagonally. Now we're going to attach the light's little main board to this metal that will hold it. And we're going to place this here and replace the big battery we had earlier. And then be careful, make sure that this goes underneath the metal here. Now we are ready to connect everything back together. We're going to connect the light to its little board. First thing we're going to connect is the power cord. That goes on the first entrance there. Second is going to be the light. Third is going to be the fan that's attached to the light. And the last thing is going to be the fan that's on the side here. Okay. Now we're going to connect the optical switch, and this goes on the very end here. This is the Z-axis motor. Okay. This is the USB. last thing is the Ethernet. Okay, now that everything is plugged in, we're going to see if it works before we close everything up. So carefully we'll turn our printer. And we're going to run a calibration test. We're going to plug in the printer. Take out the vat. Always face this down. You want to take care of your non-fat. Turn on the printer. Tools, calibrate, next. And the screen should look what is displaying up on the touch screen. Okay, to do a little, to go a little further down, you can do a dry print. You have your USB, plug it in. Go to print, and we will run the lampshade file. Okay, hit play, and you should be able to see the first layer. There's the first layer. Everything looks good. I'm going to stop this print. Stop, confirm. And it's going to keep going up, so we want to stop it. Okay, let's turn off the printer. Unplug it back. And now we can start putting everything back together. Okay, with zip ties, we just want to neatly put the cables so they're not just loosely in here. These ends. Okay, one last step, very important. Let's not forget to tighten our screws on the motherboard now. Okay, looks good in there. If it's not in place, you can move it. Okay, now that that's done, you can put the bottom back together. these are tight in there, okay? Okay, that's done. Don't forget to put your bat back in there. And you are ready to print.